Shinjuku District, Bathhouse, Tokyo, Japan. Douglas Shetland is in Tokyo and planning to meet with an unknown party to sell off the last of the information Displace gathered from Zerkesi and Morgenhold. Shetland's partners must be identified and Shetland must be stopped. Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome back to Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell Chaos Theory. Thus far, we had to take a little bit of a diversion since we figured out that Shetland was behind all of this. And we had to essentially stop the US from declaring war on the wrong party. And essentially, well, stop war as much as we could. And as a result, we had to head to Korea, both north and south, to find evidence for, you know, the attacks made possible on the US by the modified Masse Kernel algorithms. Which I don't really know how that works. Kernels are supposed to be that interface which interacts with the machine and the human, and algorithms are just... Anyhow, I'm just digressing here. But anyway, the point is that we are now free to go ahead and tackle Shetland and take him to the ground. And that is exactly what we intend to do with the Bathhouse level. With that, let's go ahead and get this.
What do you mean the attack came from Japan? They're our allies.
Mr. President, these attacks represent the most sophisticated application of information warfare ever imagined. The missile launch came through Japan, yes, but it seems likely it was triggered by elements of a private security operation, Displace International.
Displace? That's Doug Shetland's outfit. We have contracts with them.
Who's Shetland?
Former Marine Recon, among the very best. He was one of my top candidates for third echelon a few years ago. No love lost for the military or the United States. Rumor is that we hung him out to dry for political reasons over an incident that wasn't his fault. We can only speculate as to what his agenda is.
Well, how do we defuse the situation until we know?
Maybe the Chinese can help.
Gotcha.
Echelon tracked down Doug Shetland in Tokyo 6 hours ago. He's mobile and he's wireless. And from what we've managed to decrypt, it looks like he's about to wrap up his business with whoever his Japanese contacts are. From what we've managed to pick out of the air, it looks like he and his men are about to converge on a bathhouse in the middle of the city. We need to find out who Shetland is meeting with and do everything we can to prevent him from closing his deal.
Clearly, the attack that crippled the Walsh and force-launched the missile from the battery went through Seoul, but it originated in Japan. Shetland has something to do with it, and my line into the Displace servers shows that he's definitely profiteering on this war. In order to shut down his operation and prevent any further escalation, we need to ID his business partners and make sure they don't leave there with any more of Zerkesi's weaponized algorithms.
Fisher. The bathhouse where this meeting is going down is a semi-public place. There will be civilians in there, and probably a boatload of goons. Shetland's men seem to be popping up all around Tokyo in the last hour or so, and converging simultaneously on the location. Francis Coen has been in Asia for the last few months, and she's found some ties between the bathhouse ownership and a Japanese criminal organization known as the Red Nishin. It's possible that they are Shetland's partners.
Now, just one thing. Red Nishin, by the way, that's Nishin in Japanese means herring. So this is pretty much a play on words. They are foreshadowing the fact that this criminal organization is just a red herring. Anyhow,
Echelon tracked down Doug Shetland in Tokyo.
Yeah, that's what I wanted to know.
He's mobile, that's what I wanted to know.
Echelon tracked him down. I was wondering how. They managed to track him down, but at any rate, with the stealth loadout, we do get 2 smoke grenades, and I do believe that should be sufficient for us. Smoke is utilitarian at this level, and there is one part where I want to try something out. So, yeah, let's go ahead and try this mission then.
Fisher, I just got a request from Frances Coen.
What does she need?
She's been trying to get a man inside the bathhouse for a long time to keep tabs on the Red Nishin. She wants to know if you can tap the phone lines in and around the building.
Francis? Of course I can.
Uh,
And right off the bat, things get pretty hectic, as you can see right here. There is like a path to the top of the building right here at that pool over there, but I think that's one of the phones that we need to tap. Airport is sinking. Yeah, so this guy's gonna get back up and start repairing that phone. When he does that, will be my window of opportunity to make a move. Back here? Really? Interesting. I guess this guy does random stuff every single time. And that guy is literally walking into the trash can over there. He's clearly bugged out. Strange how this game works from time to time. We are trapped in this corner as of right now. Thing is, nobody's gonna be able to see us in this corner, but do I want to risk it? That guy's looking back at us again. As if he sees us. Look at this guy. Looking right at us. No, he's looking at the technician over there. That guy was looking in that direction, so we had to...
Next.
Good work, Fisher. That's the first phone line. See if you can tap into the rest.
Like, since he was looking at his buddy, we sort of got noticed along the way.
Someone moving around out there?
What's over there?
Nothing. Nothing's over there. Don't worry about it. Nothing's gonna come bite you. You can stay safe in your little hidey. Excuse me? Why gotta lag like that? Let's see till where this takes us. Sam's hanging abilities are unparalleled. But that is where you want to go, that hole down there. Damn, that looks so much better. It's a real pity that this game... you cannot see things in this game without the night vision. If you have it configured properly, that is. So at this point, we are more or less free to just take this light out. Whoops, not that. I only want to temporarily take it out, not permanently. At any rate, let me just go and save it.
It ain't supposed to do that, is it?
No, it's not.
6 weeks out of warranty, and bam, the thing starts screwing up.
And we're done.
Forget it. I don't want to find anything anyway.
Just a reminder, Sam. You'll have some civilians in the bathhouse. Do not, I repeat, do not kill any of them.
I'll be careful.
Be more than careful. Be Gandhi.
Yes, sir.
So this is yet again one of the more difficult levels of the game. Just open the trapdoor. And we can wait around here.
Central, this is 7. I finished the basement. All clear.
And we can get a move on by him, but it's...
Yeah, okay. 7 out.
Where the lights are still off. And that is exactly what I did. Saw the opportunity and I took it. risky play, but sometimes it does reward you greatly. This section also has a gentleman sitting right there. And we want to stick to the shadows behind these crates here.
Fisher, those guys don't look Japanese to me.
Yeah, expensive suits cut wide in the shoulders. They're packing for sure.
Exactly. I make them for displays, trying to keep a low profile.
Makes sense. Doug knows how to stay discreet when it's necessary.
I mean, he was supposed to be one of the alternatives to the Third Echelon program.
What was that?
Nothing much, just that the fan stopped working is all. Now what? Now we're gonna have to take the lights out.
Who switched that off?
Nobody did. It just got turned off on its own. Probably should have led with that instead.
Fisher, in order to figure out who Shetland is meeting with, you'll need to head up into the private offices. Check upstairs, to the north of your position, and past reception.
On my way.
Right then. So as soon as we enter the space, somebody switches on the lights. But there are multiple ways into the place that we want to go. This is one of the ways. I don't remember if the space had a telephone though. The place behind me, I'll have to check later. I'm pretty sure that the place in front of me does though.
Is the upstairs secure?
Yeah. Might be some Red Nishin guys up in the private rooms, but I didn't disturb them. How about the front?
It's tight. A truck is blocking the alley and I sent the guys unloading it for a coffee break. Mm-hmm.
Which guys?
Just some guys. Worker guys.
What? You just said, hey, why don't you guys take a break, and they did?
Well, I gave them 100,000 yen.
Oh, okay. Well, don't forget to expense that.
Yeah, no kidding.
Do those characters say the washroom's house? Interesting. W in the newswire, rising mercury in depleted tuna. Scientists in New Brunswick, Canada today announced the findings of a 10-year study into heavy metal contamination of fish stocks. The findings were seriously alarming, said Dr. Jules Bortlane, but ultimately not that relevant since there are no more tuna.
Further behind the leader.
Disable camera system. That's good. Right, so there's a guy right outside that's patrolling the area, and we just want to be careful of him. Don't want to bump into him.
We're on the 16th fairway with about 200 yards to the pin. He's currently 300, two behind the leader. This is a very tricky shot. Water in front of him to the right of the green.
Should be okay here, but ultimately we want to get up there, and from the looks of it, we need to climb that pole. Just waiting for this guy to get a move. Thank you. I love climbing poles, you know? Fisher loves his poles.
Oh,
So the thing is, that guy can sometimes see us from all the way down there. Like, already look at him just looking upstairs. And then there's the issue we need to wait for this guy to move before you can climb back up. Or climb up there, I mean. It's strange, how do these guys not see his fingers grabbing onto the ledge like that? Or maybe he does and he's like, no, I need some sleep. And he just goes his way. That's the only explanation that I can think of. And he's asleep as soon as he hits the bed. Amazing, amazing. Now there is like a guard outside, which is a problem. He can be there outside sometimes. Yeah, he's right there. I know safe's coming, but not really many other ways to do it. Number 93, okay. So this essentially enables us to...
Yeah.
Got it. Shetland's meeting in the private baths in the back of the bathhouse in a little while.
Who's he meeting?
Red Nishin, from the looks of it. Coen was right. The bathhouse owner is pretty high up in the Japanese mob.
I don't know. That doesn't sound like Shetland's style.
Well, unless you find something to the contrary, it looks like a solid lead to me.
I'll keep sniffing around.
Right. But
this doesn't look right.
We need to get up there before he comes in.
Fisher, those two aren't displaced. They're ISDF assault troops.
What is ISDF doing here?
Maybe the Red Nishin has sold Shetland out to the ISDF. Eavesdrop on that meeting and figure out what's going on before ISDF blows this up.
How are we going to stop them?
I'll get on the horn with Admiral Otomo and make sure we're all on the same page.
And ISDF orders report, whatever that is. And this is where the meeting will take place, by the way.
Yeah, Shetland has so much time.
And then he said something else. excuse me. I still need to like get a hang of the controls here. We got those auto reports from them, and did that like give us a note or anything? Medical kit. Shetland has arrived and is about to meet in the private baths. Shetland may be meeting with the Red Nishin, a Yakuza organization. ISDF is preparing to take Shetland down and compromise the op. I see. So that's what the ISDF is doing. Data? Any data that we have? Oh, we can actually... Right, WNM Newswire to subscriber. Walsh sailors' bodies return home. The bodies of 141 sailors from the USS Walsh returned to the United States today in preparation for funeral services. Eerie. At any rate, we can also search through the cabinets for whatever use that is. No use, apparently. Like, you can either search through the cabinets or access the computer. In most cases in this game. So the guard out there is still patrolling, by the way. And unless you have planted like a reconnaissance camera, you really don't know where he is. So best to play it a little safe. I guess the guy is headed back upstairs now. This is an electric light. Can you turn it off then? I guess it's connected to the transformer outside then. Interesting. Now, in order to avoid getting spotted by that guy outside, I'll just Yeah, wait for that guy to stop looking my way before I make my move. Now, in instances like these is where, especially if you're doing like a no-save Iron Man sort of run-through, is where the reconnaissance cameras really are useful. You can just place them in different places to essentially spy on these people. For example, around this corner, I don't know what's inside.
Just to the left of the green.
This is 9.
From here,
permit.
A short putt from
everything
a nice
is in position
car.
And we're locked up tight.
Now, can't afford to fall any further behind.
So, I didn't know that that guy was there. I was mostly relying on quick saves in case that guy was there. I could have used a quick save to, like, I could have loaded up a quick save, but if you want to do it the proper way, then you're gonna have to... I wonder where that goes. Too bad Fisher can't fit there. So, if I wanted to go there, I probably would have required a reconnaissance camera to check where it actually goes. How many of these are there, I wonder? Tap the bathhouse telephone lines. There's one up ahead, but I don't recall if this place had another or not. Okay. Two people entering this room here. I see. Are you just gonna stand there? Or are you gonna wait for it to close before you... Okay, fine. So yeah, I could not find any more phone lines to be tapped here, to be honest. This guy is just waiting right here and he's gonna turn on his flashlight soon. Holy shit, I forgot to close the door. I tend to forget that that is something that you need to do in this game. Actively close the doors once you're done using them. Alright, smoothly done, if I say so myself. We're moving on. This section, right? So then. I guess we're just gonna wait here for this guy then. Because there's like a mirror right in front of him, so even if we manage to make it to the shadows over there, he's gonna see us later. Good thing is he doesn't move past this, so we're safe here.
Well, whatever it was, it ain't here now.
Guess we can write that one off.
Way to go, Sam. Coen says there's one more phone line she'd like you to tap.
I just realized that I was speaking with my headphones on mute all this while. Now, the problem is as soon as you turn the lights out there, this worker is sweeping these halls and he just decides to run off without a second thought. Oh, they...
Whoa! You scared me there for a second. Sorry. Visibility
okay, this, I've been retrying this section for
something goes down, be next to impossible
forever now.
Got any night vision?
But
here?
Yeah, this is one of the ways that you can take.
Maybe if we had thermal,
go right by them. Just have to because of
yeah. Fortunately, Mogadishu, I don't hear so.
The
good.
Fog, you were with which makes it difficult for them
no,
to see.
I was kind of working for General ID, but only indirectly. Oh, forget I asked.
Working for General ID in Mogadishu. I'm just waiting for this section to get flooded with fog as well. Do I? Well, I guess we can do that. Let us turn off the steam in this area. Make it hard to see. That is as fast as we can walk because of the steam in the area now. The water is also hot. Whoops, nothing can be seen right now. Yeah, let's just turn the turret off. Good decision, I do believe. I can't even see the turret, to be honest. Ah, this section, of course. And right here is when shit starts hitting the fan. Sorry, I was a little too focused on actually playing through these sections that I forgot to commentate on them. But there's like a guy in front of us that we need to be careful of. I do not know where he is at this point, but yeah, he's around the corner somewhere. And this is the last phone line that we need to tap.
Next.
That's the last phone line, Fisher. Coen sends her thanks.
Tell her it was my pleasure.
So it was. Yeah, so there's a guy here that we want to be a little cautious of. There he is. Thankfully, they're not exactly using, night vision yet. So we can securely stay in the shadows where they can't see us. Because, well, shadows are the night vision's worst enemy. Sorry, light is the night vision's worst enemy. We should be fine right here. Moving along this side here, getting behind this thing to conceal ourselves. Sort of timed it well. Right, so as soon as this guy goes away, we are not free to move because there's another guy moving about out there. And Yeah, he's gonna like come here and pose a little first.
Zachary!
Yes, sir.
I just double checked the blueprints. Turns out there's a vent that comes out in the meeting room. ISDF makes me nervous. Make sure the vent is clear of any surveillance gear.
Yes, sir.
Be quick about it. The meeting will start soon.
I'm on it.
At times I'm surprised by how these folks cannot hear Sam moving through, you know, the vents like that, or see his feet sticking out. Because look at this, Sam's feet would be sticking out like crazy. But at any rate, that vent that we're talking about is essentially the one that we want to access. To that effect, this technician has been tasked with closing that vent up, but, well, we're gonna try and get a move on it anyway. Oh yeah, he's going around and checking for bugs in vents and stuff. But typically, there's a guy here who can spot you. I've never faced that bug on the PC version, but who knows, maybe it'll be different for this playthrough.
Lambert, ISDF is in the building. Are they making their move?
It's all clear.
Sir, I've completed installation.
I haven't been able to contact Otomo. I don't know what's going on.
Wait a minute.
Yes, this will do just fine.
So that guy is wearing nitrogen and he can typically spot us.
I told you I've taken care of everything. We're secure.
Jesus, Lambert. ISDF isn't here to take Shetland down. They're meeting with him. They're his partners.
My God. Stay there. We need to hear the details before we go to the Joint Chiefs with this.
Did not bring them? We're not going to follow you across Tokyo.
Relax, Kaneda. I'll just download them and burn you a disk.
Huh? You take me for a fool. You are not stupid enough to download them over a public network. What are you up to?
I said relax. You're right. I'm not that stupid. My men just finished setting up a shadow net. Completely secure wireless, discreet from the web. Now sit. You'll have your algorithms in about 4 minutes. Call it!
Lambert.
Let it go, Fisher. We know the truth. We'll pick up the pieces after the dust settles.
Save it, Kaneda. I've seen it before. You're defending your honor to cover up your lies. Should I check the account? Or should we start shooting and see who walks out of here?
Kaneda! That's...
Oh, damn.
No! No, no! Please! We can work this out!
We're switching the fallback.
The chopper's on its way.
Good. Secure this area. No one comes through.
Yes, sir.
Fisher?
Kill Shetland. I know.
Good thinking, Fisher. Looks like Shetland is using Zerkezi's infinite recursion code to run genetic algorithms that allow him to remotely organize his men.
Why?
Wow. DOD is gonna love this. Looks like Shetland can establish his objectives, and the software will break it down to individual tasks and mail them out to his men.
Damn. So his people all swarm a target location independently and complete the sub-objectives without ever knowing what the plan is.
Exactly. Kind of a bizarre inverse of Nikolaj's glass dagger.
Glass dagger, huh? I think that's the first time I've heard of it. Anyhow. Chaos theory, from Cattle to Shetland. Sir, I've completed installation of the requested algorithms and installed the required software. In order to maintain operation security, all that is required is entry of the tasks and subtasks and allocation of the number of assets and execution time and location. The algorithm will then generate the mission plan and contact your men remotely when needed. And that is essentially how Shetland reverse engineered the Masse Kernels for his own gain. It still remains, well, we still have to eliminate Shetland. Now, the next few sections are going to be pretty difficult.
There he is! Got it!
And yeah, even though the music is picking up, it doesn't really have much to do with us, to be honest. Use terminal force, of course. I know. That looks.
Nail that bastard! Over there! Use terminal force!
Right, so this way we go back. Oh, not that. Get a little tense, and I'm sad to say that I was spotted. Very sad to say that. So over here is where you want to like get a running start and just go through the chase. If you want, you can go there and pick up Shetland's laptop. But yeah, it's really not required. Right here is where the difficult part begins. I do have another smoke grenade which I will be using. The difficult part is that this section has splinter cells with goggles on. Not splinter cells, but... Okay, the problem is right now I've got only one smoke grenade and I typically use like two of them for this section here. Let's try tossing it there. Maybe it'll make a difference. Let us hope that it will. Looks like it did. Cool. And, well, I do want to try something new for the next section here. There are no issues here. We have made it past that section that we needed to make past. We can just walk past this. We don't really need to disarm it or anything. But here is where the fun begins. Which is luck.
This is pointless, Sam. You won't know what to do if you catch me. Why bother chasing?
My God, Fisher! Shetland has rigged the place to blow! There are bombs hidden in the furnace room. You'll have to find them all, and fast!
On it, Lambert. So the first bomb is right here. And this section might take a few retries if you don't know where to look for the bombs. And he comes along to tease you, sort of.
Mason and Lambert have you wrapped around their fingers, Fisher. And no more to them than any other weapon.
We can move on to the next part. Okay, the next one is over there, and I just hope that this guy cannot see me. To ensure that I'm moving as slowly as possible, but these guys are somehow able to see me all the time. Which is something that I find quite strange, to be honest. Like, just look at that guy, he's running off to, you know, investigate things on his own. He's not supposed to do that.
I've lost him! He's back somewhere! You've made yourself the
Okay, we need to use this now. And no one is a nice guy. Am I done? Okay. Somehow this guy is able to... Like, this guy is already alert somehow. This is sad because I wanted to try something out for this level. This is bugged for some reason. These guys are not supposed to be able to see me like that.
You've made yourself the instrument of a policy you don't believe in, Sam. Walk away!
We're stuck here.
Looks like we've got trouble.
Right. I'll just wait for his buddy to come along and I'll shoot him as well.
What's going on here?
Better stick close to the wall till then. Come on, hurry it up, will you? Oh, come on. I haven't got all day here. Where's... Oh yeah, right, the bomb's here. Behind this here section.
Your honor for their agenda.
Yeah, see a line and run. Why don't you? I just want to stand here in complete light and hopefully that'll make me invisible to this guy here. Come on then. No, I'm not. Sort of hurt myself there, but oh well. It's all over now. And time to pick up the pieces. This level was bugged, I dislike that. Hoo-hoo.
It doesn't have to end like this, Sam.
No, but it does have to end.
On that we agree. We've been fighting their dirty little wars our entire lives, and where do we end up? Staring at each other down the barrels of our guns. Nothing has changed, Fisher. And it won't change by degrees. We have to tear it down and start over. It's the only way.
Your own little chaos theory. Throw the world into war and hope that what comes out the other side is better.
It will be better. Because this war will change things, Sam. Every other war has been about keeping things the same, but the status quo doesn't work anymore. America's sick, Sam. She's dying. The politicians, the bureaucrats, the whispered backroom deals, it's all life support for a sick old lady who was dead a long time ago.
The only backroom deals that I've seen lately were made by you. You're a murderer and a war criminal.
Those are the only names the state has for the revolutionary, Sam. You only become a hero after the war is over. You know the truth. The world is built from the bottom up, not the other way around. Honor, courage, fidelity. We don't inherit these things from the world, Sam. We build the world from them. I know you. You believe in these things more than any government. And I know that because of it, you wouldn't shoot an old friend.
That is true. Because I wouldn't knife him.
Right, Doug. I wouldn't shoot an old friend.
And that was that for Mission Bathhouse. Now, the last section, the enemies were just aware of me, instantly aware of me, and that is... that little, like, threw the entire game out for me, because, I mean, it was strange. It's like, as soon as the action picked up, all the enemies could just magically see me, and, like, that tendency like stuck around. I mean, ever since you know, Douglas shot Tetsuo, or was it Kaneda? Yeah. That, by the way, is an Akira reference. It's an animated movie from it's the 70s or the 90s, I forgot. I think it's the 70s, but yeah, all our objectives have been completed, and our bonus objective has also been completed. And now I don't know who saw me or how they saw me, but apparently the night vision now gives these people the ability to see through walls for whatever reason, which is sort of strange, which is very strange, because I've never really encountered this bug before. Maybe I'll have to reinstall this game and hopefully it makes things better, because I was not planning to do things this way. I was planning to try out something drastically different with this level, but Well, it just didn't work out. The enemies could see me through the walls and everything, so I had no option but to engage in combat and take them out. The thing about this game is once the combat starts, the enemies, they typically know where you are, even if you are not visible, like be it in the shadows or in the light. So I guess that is one of the oversights of developing chaos theory. Maybe they didn't exactly want to develop it as as a shooter game, even though they did give us the option to play it that way. But I guess more will be revealed to us as we complete more of this mission. But 38 and a half minutes in Bathhouse, it felt longer than that for me because I had to retry a lot of the sections, especially towards the end. I mean, Bathhouse was never that brutal for me. I mean, as soon as I got out of that vent, you could hear somebody just shout, "There he is!" And as soon as I entered the, what is that thing, the vent, they could just see me right off the bat. So it's pretty strange. It's actually pretty strange why this bug occurred. I have no idea. It may have something to do with the 13 EG's widescreen fix, because, or maybe it's the fact that I'm playing this on Windows 11. I'll try running it with the Windows XP compatibility settings. I previously played this on Windows 10, not on 11, so maybe that is what the issue is here. But it's a very, very jarring sort of a bug there. But with all of this having been done, Shetland is out of the picture, but he was meeting with the ISDF to essentially sell them the software. And basically, hinting at the fact that he was working with the ISDF, if you go back to the, eavesdrop on the Shetland's meeting before the ISDF takes him out, they weren't there to take him out, they were working with Shetland. So this now pulls our focus onto the Japanese ISDF, which takes us to find out who gave the ISDF assault team their orders here. Which takes us to the next mission and the final mission of this game. Even though this is more apt for a finale, but in true Splinter Cell style, the final mission is always one where you tie up the loose ends. And that is what we will be doing with the last mission as well, when we head to Kokubu Sosho in Japan essentially bring, apprehend General Otomo from the ISDF. As for Mission Bathhouse, thank you so much for tuning in, thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much for sticking around until the end. I just wish that bug wasn't a part of this game, but it's strange, but the bug really ruined the experience for me, because I was super excited to try something drastically new, but I just couldn't do that. The enemies just saw me through walls and everything, so it's pretty strange how that works, and pretty strange where that happened, but it happened. Can't really do anything about it, no other way around it, so So the hint to what I was trying to do is pretty simple. I was actually trying to stay in the light, because when you're in the light, especially during the bomb defusal section, is when you're in the light, the enemies cannot see you. So that is essentially what I was trying to, especially when they're wearing night vision. This is something that I realized while playing through Pantoro tomorrow. This is something that I wanted to try out, but unfortunately it was bugged for me. Anyhow, the next time we come back, we will be covering Kokubu Sosho. Until then, take care. Fare thee well, fellow things.